Hello everyone, today we are going to see the program to find reverse of a given number. For example, if the input is 123, we have to print the result as reverse of a number is 321. This is the basic prototype which you have to use in each Java program. You have to import the scanner class to take the input and public static void main, then we will create the object of a scanner class. Now for each number based program, as we discussed in the earlier video, we have to remember two steps. Number one, n modulo 10 to extract last digit. And n is equal to n by 10 to remove last digit. Why do we need to do this? Because whatever operations we want to perform with a given number, whatever operation we want to perform with the given number, we have to extract each digit one by one. Now in this, to find reverse of a number, we have to extract the digits and we have to change its place value. Means 123, here 3 is at the unit place, tens place, hundreds place. What will we do? We will extract the digit 3. Right now it is at the unit place, right? Or ones place you can say. You have to shift it to tens place, then hundreds place. So what will happen? We have to make this 321. Now 3 is at hundreds place, 2 is at tens place, and 1 is at ones place. So how will we do? Let us see the logic. For each number based program, we have to remember, first we will take the number from the user. Let us take system.out.println. I'll ask user, enter the number. Int n is equal to s dot next int. I took the number from the user. Now what is the for loop? For semicolon, as initialization is already done here, number we have taken, n greater than 0, we have to repeat how many times? Till my number reaches 0. Updation step, we will keep blank because we are going to do updation for a number inside the for loop. Now what will we do? We will extract the digit. X is equal to n modulo 10. I extracted the digit, extract last digit. For any number program, this step is fixed. Next, n is equal to n by 10 is also fixed. What will it do? It removes the last digit. It removes last digit from the number. What does it mean? If I'm remove, if my number, suppose, let us say my number is 2345, right? So what will it do? This step will give me 5, then 4, then 3, then 2. Why it is repetitive? Because it is put in the for loop. And because of this line, your original number will change to 235, 234, 23, 2, right? Now, in between these two steps, we have to think based on your question, you have to decide the step. Now here, we will find reverse in the reverse variable is equal to reverse into 10 plus x. Why into 10 plus x? What is rev? It's the integer int rev. In the beginning it is 0. What is x? It is also an integer. Whatever digit we will extract, as we discussed earlier, 5 is at the unit place, it is extracted. Then in the beginning what will happen? Reverse is 0. So 0 into 10, that is 0, plus x, x is 5, so it will become, reverse variable will be 5. Next, when the for loop will run again, what will happen? The next digit extracted will be 4, so 5 was already there in the reverse, 5 into 10, 50, plus 4. In short, we are changing the places, positions, or we can say place value. 5 is at the unit place, it will be shifted to tens place, then hundreds place, then thousands place, one by one. Once you will come out of this for loop, we will print the result. System.out.println. Reverse of a given number is plus rev. Okay, what's the error? We have not commented this. So let us comment this line. These are the extra programming lines. So we will comment this and again we will run. It is executed properly, compiled. Now let us run the program. Enter the number. Suppose I enter 345, it will give me the 345 reverses 543. Again, let us run, enter the number 5643. What will it do? Reverse of a number is 3465. So what does it mean? In this, line number 22 and line number 26 is fixed. Extract the digit. Why this logic? To change the place value of each digit. To change place value of digit. First 5 is extracted. Change it to tens place, then hundreds place, and so on. And these two steps, as we discussed, are common for each number based program.